Love and hate are important human emotions that are of long-standing interest in psychology. They seem opposites at the first sight, but despite these two emotions seemingly laying far apart, they are not. The line between the two may be thin, and it could be easy to shift between these two in one small event. The intention to argue less with your partner seems like a good idea, isn't it? But is it so? In this and my next video, I am going to answer this question and will give you some insights to fair and safe fighting strategies to strengthen your relationship. So stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of my new content I publish every week. I'm a healthcare psychologist and therapist, and I make videos on psychology and mental health topics. Conflicts in any meaningful relationship is inevitable. All couples fight. It's completely natural and comes with the territory of being in a relationship. Conflicts arise when the needs, goals, or preferences of partners intersect. Arguing is a good thing for a couple. It enriches and brings you closer to each other, but if you are doing it right, at least. So if you sometimes fight with each other, it's absolutely no reason to worry. We often have a lot in common with our partners, but it does not exclude the possibility that there are differences. However, when you find yourself arguing more than usual, it's natural to wonder how much fighting is too much. There are various ways to deal with a conflict. You can resolve the disagreement during a quiet discussion, but in the worst case, it escalates and culminates in verbal aggression and sometimes physical violence. A disagreement and an escalated conflict should not be measured by the same standard. The focus of the disagreement is on the content. It's about the way in which a certain subject is being looked at. That can be difficult, but this does not mean that there is an escalated conflict. There is a dysfunctional conflict when the focus shifts from the content or subject of the disagreement to the person in front of you. When someone is blamed for a certain behavior or a personal trait, without blaming, there is no conflict. The most common conflicts in relationships between couples are very different from those of the previous generations. Due to transformation of family structures and also gender roles, new sources of conflicts have emerged. The emotional demands change too, as well as expectations which couples must meet in our modern society. This explains why the most common conflicts in relationships are related to constraints and power issues. For example, one of the two partners wants to take absolute control. There are conflicting needs for independence, affection, closeness, satisfaction, and happiness. Next one is when your partner has different priorities and expectations regarding the relationship. Many couples who go to family therapy have communication problems. They often feel that their partner doesn't understand them. Partners are avoiding talking with each other about their fears or weaknesses. Lack or loss of trust is one of the most harmful things to a couple's long-term success. Numerous studies have identified communication as one of the top reasons for breakup and divorce. Next issue is when there is no real differentiation from the birth families, like independence. both birth families can interfere in the lives of partners when there is not enough distance available. Family members still impose their opinions on every fight the couple have. But the best predictor of divorce is when one or both partners show contempt in the relationship. This is the opposite of respect and is often expressed via criticism or sarcasm regarding the worth of an individual. So, if contemptuous communication is central in a conflict between two partners, it will destroy the health of a relationship like poison. Instead of viewing arguing as a bad thing, experts agree that in a relationship, conflict can usually be healthy. This is an opportunity to learn more about your partner and how you can work together as a team. A conflict arises because the other is doing something that is sensitive or even painful. Expressing a feeling or fight has the advantage that partners can better understand each other. One can understand better what is important to the other and vice versa. And this understanding will diminish their communication issues. When couples fight, it means they care about relationship. It brings them together. Avoiding that pain does not make the pain go away. If a couple would tell me they never fight, then I would be worried. Not fighting with your partner may indicate different issues. Maybe you are tired of sharing your true feelings, or you don't trust your partner to handle your feelings. Fighting is a sign of a good and healthy relationship, but on one condition: if you do it in the right way. However, be careful, because a conflict can quickly turn into a battle which neither partner benefits from. On the other hand, if you fight in an honest and safe way, even if you're a newly couple, your relationship has a big chance of success. To do this, partners must learn to listen to each other, so it can become clear why something is sensitive to a person. Escalated conflicts occur when the accusations rise up. They grow bigger and become more personal. A well-known way to reduce conflicts is to go back, to ask the other, where did our fight begin? If you go back to where you came from, there is more chance you will laugh about it. And always remember, you can't control anyone else's behavior. The only one in your charge is you. Healthy fighting is necessary from time to time to vent your feelings and to express your frustrations. And that's how we learn to understand each other better. That is why arguing can be enriching and brings about more connectedness between partners. You share something of yourself, you trust somebody, so you build something together. Arguing indicates that you care about your relationship. When a couple stops arguing, that can mean that one of the partners abandons the relationship and therefore no longer finds worth fighting for. Relationship becomes completely hopeless when both partners have given up and only indifferences remains. Next week, I will give you some do's and don'ts of a good fight. So be sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell before you go. Feel free to express your thoughts in the comments down below or on my Facebook or Instagram pages. But also give this video a thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.